Alright guys and girls, I'm Obsidian Ant and welcome to 3304. This is where I take a look at the news and happenings in and around Elite Dangerous. New technology for the Guardian FSD booster has been pulled from the game. In the system Pollux, there's a D-Day message, but what's it all about? And Dr. Anthony Ross discusses the Milky Way galaxy. The introduction of new technology in the form of modules and weapons now appears to be a regular and ongoing feature of Elite Dangerous. Last week, three new items arrived: the Guardian Distributor, the Shard Cannon, and the Guardian FSD Booster. These can be unlocked via the Guardian Tech Brokers, and they require a whole load of various Guardian-related materials, most notably the Guardian Blueprints, which can only be gained from the ruin sites. However, not everything was smooth running. Players quickly noticed that the Guardian FSD booster appeared to not be working correctly. In fact, it appeared to not be working at all. Now, on average, the booster gives around an additional 10 light years of jump range. However, when trying to engage the drive, the player was informed that the jump exceeds available fuel. This occurs regardless of how much fuel the ship has, no matter how small the jump distance. So, Frontier soon pulled the booster from the game, stating that they will re-implement the drive when it is fixed. This morning, that's today on Monday, they posted a further update. All players who unlock the Guardian FSD will be reimbursed the cost of the materials they used. And as a way of apology to these players, they will still retain access to the drive when it comes live again. An in-game message informs players that the replacement module will arrive in patch 3.1, but it doesn't give us a date for this, unfortunately. The same message also informs players how and where to retrieve their materials. So if you did purchase this module in the game, then do check your in-game messages, because there's a little message there waiting for you. What does a 150-year-old French poem have to do with Elite? Well, that's kind of a trick question, as the answer is that no one seems to know. Well, at least they didn't up until a few hours ago, when Frontier confirmed that the first few lines of this poem were placed in the game in a form of a message as a memorial for a player, Commander Tony Pox, who unfortunately passed away last year. Now, this is an awesome gesture from Frontier, and I'm sure it will be highly appreciated by all those that knew the player. Naturally, events surrounding the activation of the message have caused quite a stir though within the game and the community as a whole, as players were unaware that this was intended as a memorial beacon. Many players quite reasonably assumed that this was the next step in the ongoing Thargoid mystery. On Thursday, a message was intercepted by a beacon in the Pollux system within the game. The message translated into the first few lines of the French poem Autumn Song, to give it its English name. And this message is of great historical significance, as it was used by the Allies in 1944 to signal a countdown to D-Day, a key turning point in World War II. However, its context in Elite served up some serious confusion. Historically, the first line of the poem was broadcast by the BBC to give 2 weeks' notification of D-Day, with the second line being broadcast to give 48 hours' notice. Players and groups such as Canon Research scrambled to decode this new apparent mystery, and over the weekend it spawned numerous videos, Reddit posts and forum updates. In the end though, such an abundance of activity within the game is of course a fantastic addition to the memorial itself. The galaxy within Elite is arguably the game's single best asset, and it's totally unarguably the largest one. One of the lead developers behind the generation of the galaxy is Frontier lead renderer programmer Anthony Ross. There's a good chance anyone who went to Frontier Expo in 2017 will have bumped into him, or at the very least heard his talk on the creation of the game's galaxy. Website 80Level has now posted a very nice article written by Anthony Ross himself, going into great detail on all the matters of the Milky Way and its place within Elite Dangerous. He discusses the generation of planets, their size, coloration, and many other things besides. It's an interesting read, not only because it informs the immense work that has gone into the galaxy, but also because of how many elements of the design plug directly into gameplay. The distribution of various planetary materials is a good example of this. A link to the full article can be found in the video description below. This week's community goal is on behalf of the player group, the Atlas Corporation. The aim of the community goal is to construct a new megaship in the Lambda Area system. There are currently 2 CGs in place for the Atlas Corporation. One is a bounty hunting community goal, and the other is a trading one. Upon completion, the Atlas Corp plan on calling their ship the ACS Overwatch. They state that it will serve as a coordination point for the rescue missions and anti-Thargoid operations, as well as being a valuable resupply point and a safe haven for the people of the Lambda Aurea system. Meanwhile, a third community goal is also active. This one is for the Pioneers Alliance, with the aim of building a military outpost in HIP 33368. Details on all three community goals can be found in the video description. That then brings us to an end of this episode of 3304. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys and girls next time.